star. Now, because Victoria's Secret does not know how to hold a too much woman, I had to go to a specialty store. And I walked into this specialty store and I was fingering a little leopard thumb. And the saleswoman comes over to me and she says, "Honey, if you like that, you're gonna love this." And she was holding this barely there leopard teddy on a hanger. Now, I was choked on my tongue. There's no Madonna would have blushed looking at that. But I could see the determination in her eyes, so I just smiled and took it from her with no intention of trying it on. And there I go into the change room with my fairly risque leopard print. I have a thing for animal print, if you haven't guessed. Leopard printed, fairly reasonable under things. And when I got there, I sat on a little velvet cushion to take my shoes off, and I looked up at that little leopard teddy, and it's hard to believe, but it looked back at me. And it was almost sneering. And all of a sudden, I felt this contempt well up in my body for this non-animated piece of cloth. I felt contempt swoop over me like a hot flash. And I thought, "I hate you." That's actually what I thought. "I hate you. I hate you for everything that you are bringing up in me. I hate you for making me feel ashamed. I hate you for the fear that I have just looking at you. I hate you that I'm scared to even think of trying you on by myself in this little room and looking at my reflection in the mirror. I hate you for all the men that you represent where I never felt safe. I hate you for all the women that you represent that make me feel bad about my body. I hate you for all of the ways that sitting here right now, I'm crying by myself in a change room, and you're a damn piece of cloth, and I hate you for that." And I sat there at that moment, and I had a pity party, and I was flooded with shame because here I am. I've traveled the world speaking to women, telling them to stand in their power. And I was outpowered by a piece of freaking cloth. So you know what I did, didn't you? You know what I did. I took that teddy and I marched right over to the counter and I bought her. But not only did I buy her, I wore her for 1 week straight. I wore her under my sweats. I wore her under my jeans. I wore her under my business clothes. I wore her to bed. I wore her constantly for 1 week. I wore her to a PTA meeting. Oh, meeting. I wore her on a business call. God, they only knew. But I wore her. I let the rub of the fabric touch me. It burned in some places. It got me really close to myself. That's why they're called intimates. It held up a mirror to all the places I didn't want to look my whole life. And something changed in me wearing that teddy. And nobody knew it. I felt like I had this secret that nobody knew. Imagine me in the grocery store, walking down the aisle. It changed something in me, and nobody had to know. And this has nothing to do with sexuality. A lot of people mistake the too much woman for a woman who just wants to have it all out there. But this is me, and being connected to my sensuality means being connected to my senses. It's all the ways that I can take my senses and kick it up a notch, like Emeril Lagasse, man, kick it up a notch. So O is for, what gives you pleasure, literally and figuratively? And I want to make a case and ask a question. What would happen? happen if tomorrow every single one of you prioritized your pleasure before servitude? What would happen? What would change at home if you said, I am not doing anything for anyone until I pleasure myself, whatever that means? Maybe it's taking a bath. Maybe it's dancing. Maybe it's lying in bed and reading a book. What does that mean for you? And what would happen if you prioritize